In this decade, Americans began smoking fewer cigarettes for the first time since 1913. That's when R.J. Reynolds took a picture of a Barnum & Bailey circus camel and stuck it on the side of a pack. 6 years later, nearly half the people in America who smoke cigarettes smoked that one brand. His ads were the first to link smoking with the good life.
If you want to smoke a cigarette that's mild and good tasting too, try Camel. I did.
That didn't just sell cigarettes. It made them part of our culture.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening to you.
NBC's first TV newscast even gave them away.
Well, you know, the makers of Camels are both pleased and privileged to send thousands of packs of gift cigarettes each week to members of our armed forces and hospitalized veterans.
Stand by.
Today, one of R.J. Reynolds' grandsons, Patrick, is twisting those advertising techniques to get people to stop smoking.
My grandfather, R.J. Reynolds, chewed tobacco and died of cancer. My father, R.J. Reynolds Jr., smoked heavily and died of emphysema. I smoked for 10 years, and I have small airways lung disease.
Patrick Reynolds is not seriously ill, but he has sold his stock in the company that made him rich and is now an unlikely spokesman for the American Lung Association.
My memories of my father are of a man always short of breath, increasingly sick and frail, and counting the time he had left to live.
His brother Mike agrees that children should not smoke, but says others in the Reynolds family feel adults should have a choice.
If you don't smoke, don't start. But if you must, smoke a Reynolds product.
Patrick was a movie actor before joining the anti-smoking crusade. Critics say he is simply looking for a new role that will make him famous. He denies that he's an opportunist, but admits,
there is pressure on me to do something wonderful. Otherwise, I'm not living up to the family name.
Practically every rainbow the Reynolds family ever followed had a pot of gold at the end. Besides tobacco, Patrick's father also helped bankroll Delta Airlines. Others started Reynolds Securities and Reynolds Aluminum.
My parents were such legendary figures. I mean, it seemed like so much to live up to. I remember coming back here and feeling little, like I wasn't measuring up to the legend of my father and my mother.
Patrick grew up in palaces built from cigarette profits. This one, on an island off the Georgia coast, has a ballroom big enough to hold a circus tent. His dad bought the mansion shortly after the stock market crash of 1929.
It's a dream, and I don't know that it's always a happy dream. When I was 3, my parents were divorced, and when I was 9, I wrote him a letter, which followed him around the world. And when the letter got into his hands, he opened it and he read it, and it said, "Dear Dad, I'm your son Patrick. Where are you?"
His father summoned Patrick to his side.
He was still smoking cigarettes then, and he was dying from them.
That is why Patrick Reynolds hates cigarettes. His grandfather was an advertising genius who lured millions to start smoking. Patrick hopes he has inherited that power to persuade.
And if I can use it to save lives and make a difference in this world, what greater gift could I have had than that? Maybe I got the greatest inheritance of all.
The Reynolds family is still close, despite Patrick's anti-smoking campaign. But one wonders what old R.J. would think of a grandson using his marketing techniques to stop the sale of cigarettes. Bob Dotson, NBC News, Sapelo Island, Georgia.